Hello friends, welcome to lecture number 5 for chapter number 6, Combustion in CNG. So in previous lecture we discussed the requirements of combustion chamber in CNG, various types of combustion chamber used in CNG, and in that we discussed the open combustion chamber, that is known as direct injection combustion chamber, and various types of this open combustion chambers, namely shallow depth, hemispherical, cylindrical and toroidal shape. After that we also discuss the indirect injection combustion chambers or divided combustion chambers. So there are three types of indirect injection combustion chambers, namely swirl chamber, second pre-combustion chamber and third one air cell or energy cell. So in previous lecture we discussed the swirl chamber, which is the type of the compression swirl. So in swirl chamber the compression swirl method is to be used. Now in today's lecture we will see the next combustion chamber, that is the type of the indirect injection combustion chamber, pre-combustion chamber. Getting pre-combustion chamber. So here the figure is to be shown of this pre-combustion chamber. So this pre-combustion chamber is again the type of the indirect injection combustion chamber, where we are going to use the combustion induced the swirl. Correct. So combustion swirl method is to be used in pre-combustion chamber. So typical pre-combustion chamber consists of an anti-chamber or pre-combustion chamber. So such an anti-chamber or additional chamber known as pre-chamber is to be provided in the cylinder head, which is connected with the main chamber. So this pre-chamber is connected to the main chamber through the number of small holes. In the figure only you see the one hole, orifice. Orifice means small opening. So the pre-chamber is communicated with the main chamber through the different small holes. Now compared to relatively large passage in the swirl chamber, as in case of swirl chamber the throat passage is a smaller. Getting in swirl chamber the throat which connects tangentially with the swirl chamber with the main chamber, it is a very restricted passage, but in this case there are number of holes are there. So that is a large passage available between the pre-chamber and main combustion chamber. So the pre-combustion chamber is located in the cylinder head. So just imagine it is to be constructed in a cylinder head. Getting this anti-chamber or pre-chamber or this additional chamber is constructed in the cylinder head, and its volumes accounts for about 40% of total combustion space. Means whatever the 100% of combustion space is available, out of which 40% of combustion will be occurred in the pre-chamber. Getting, so 40% of total combustion space is account for the pre-chamber. So during the compression stroke, what happens when compression stroke is starts from the bottom dead center to the top dead center? So when piston moves from BDC to the TDC, so during this compression stroke piston forces the air into the pre-combustion chamber through the small these openings. Through these small openings, through this number of small holes or passages. Getting, so air is to be forced into the pre-chamber through these passages. Getting, in the pre-combustion chamber, and the fuel is injected in the pre-chamber and the combustion is initiated. Getting, so here the fuel is to be injected by using the pintle or single or pintox nozzle. Getting, single hole nozzle or pintle nozzle or pintox nozzle. By any type of that nozzle we are going to inject the fuel in the pre-combustion chamber, and the combustion is initiated. Combustion is now commences. So the resulting pressure rise in this pre-chamber forces the flaming droplets together with some air and their combustion products that will be rushed out into the main chamber through these passages at high velocity. Meaning, so combustion is first initiated in this pre-chamber, whatever the flaming droplets that results from the combustion, whatever the combustible droplets that results from this combustion, they are going to be rushed out from this pre-chamber to the main chamber through these small openings, through these orifices, meaning at higher velocities, and thereby it creates the secondary turbulence, means it creates the secondary swirl motion, that is a air motion in the main chamber, and thus it creates the both strong secondary turbulence and distributes the flaming or this combustible droplets throughout the air in the main chamber, getting in the main combustion chamber, and here the bulk combustion takes place, getting, and here the bulk combustion takes place. So about 80% of energy is released in a main combustion chamber, getting. So here the main combustion will be carried out in a main combustion chamber. So the rate of pressure rise and the maximum pressure is lower compared to those in open type chamber, meaning because firstly the pressure rise will be occurs in pre chamber, then during the second it will be in the main chamber, means whatever the pressure rise and the maximum pressure is lowered compared to the open combustion chamber, where the pressure rise is going to occur during the second stage only. Getting, here it is not softening, here the pressure will be rapid in during the third stage, and that is better to avoid the knocking. Getting, that is avoid the knocking. So the initial shock if combustion is limited to the pre-combustion chamber only. So the pre-combustion chamber has multi-fuel capability without any modification in the injection system, means multi-fuel ability is to be use, means any type of fuel that is to be used, getting, any type means it is not sensitive on that front, it is not sensitive on the type of the fuel used, getting, because of that, because the temperature of pre-chamber, getting, because the temperature of the pre-chamber. So that is about the pre-combustion chamber. Advantage, so advantage first is due to the short delay period, or practically there is no delay period. If you see, the combustion is started in a pre-chamber only, getting, and the bulk combustion that will be occurs in a main chamber, but initially combustion will be common sense, it will started at the pre-chamber. So in this manner there is a short delay period or practically no delay period, getting, for the fuel which is entering from the pre-chamber to the main combustion chamber, because the fuel is start to burn in a pre-chamber, because of that practically there is no delay period, getting, and because of that the tendency of knock is minimum and engine will runs smoothly. Second advantage, the combustion in a third stage is rapid, because here if you see the pressure rise during the second stage, that will be smooth, that is will be lower, maximum pressure rise will be, that is a lower in a second stage, getting. So in a third stage the combustion will be rapid, getting. Then the fuel injection system design need not be critical, getting. So injection pressure is not matter in this case, getting. Injection pressure is not required much in this type of the combustion chambers, so it is not to be critical, getting, because the mixing of fuel and air takes place in a pre-chamber only. It is not takes place in the open combustion, means in main combustion chamber. It will be before main combustion chamber, the mixing will be occurs, and that's why injection pressure required less. Getting, so that is the advantages of the pre-combustion chamber. Next disadvantage, the velocity of burning mixture too high. The velocity of burning mixture too high, getting. So velocity of burning mixture which is coming from the pre-chamber to the main chamber is too high, and because of that there may be chances of loss of heat, getting, there may be chances of loss of heat. So when high flaming droplet that is comes from this pre-chamber to the main combustion chamber, during that period there may be chances of loss of heat, getting, loss of heat. that will be reduced as the thermal efficiency. Getting that will be reduced as the thermal efficiency. One can offset this problem by using the high compression ratio engines. Then cold starting will be difficult. So cold starting problem that will be arises in this case. Cold starting will be difficult as air losses heat to chamber walls during the compression. So when we are going to compress the air, and when air moves from main chamber to the pre-chamber, so there may be chances of loss of heat from the compressed air, and that will cause the cold starting problem. The cold starting problem will be arises in that case. Next, we'll discuss the energy cell. About the pre-combustion. So energy cell, it is also known as the air cell. So the energy cell is more complex than the pre-combustion chamber. Why it is complex? In the complex, in the matter of the construction of the chamber, getting construction of the chamber, it is very precise design is to be needed in the construction of these additional chambers, in these divided chambers. So if you see the figure, as the piston moves up in the compression stroke, means from BDC to the TDC, when piston moves, some of the air is forced into the major and minor cell. Getting into the major and minor cell. Getting into the major and minor cells, chambers of the energy cell. So these are the major and minor cells of the energy cell. So when the fuel is injected to the pintle type, again in divided chamber we use the single hole pintle type or pintoxer. Here it is used the pintle type. If fuel is injected through this pintle type nozzle, part of fuel passes across the main chamber. Into the minor cell. Getting when it moves across this main chamber, it enters into the minor cell where it is mixed with the air. That is where it is mixed with the entering air through this main combustion chamber. So combustion first commences in the main combustion chamber. Combustion is firstly at the main combustion chamber where the temperature is higher, because in the main combustion chamber only highly compressed air is to be consist. Correct. It is at the main chamber, and that's why the combustion is initially started at the main combustion chamber. But the rate of the burning is slower. Here the rate of the burning is slower. Why it is slower? Because the mixing is not uniform. Meaning mixing is not proper in main combustion chamber at the initial stage. Whereas the combustion in the minor cell will be started after the main combustion chamber. Getting so burning in minor cell is slower at the start, but due to the better mixing of this fuel and air, the combustion progresses more rapidly in the minor cell. Getting so here the combustion is a rapid. Here combustion is a rapid because the mixing is good compared to the main combustion chamber. It is much good in a minor cell compared to the main combustion chamber, and therefore the pressure built up in the minor cell. So in the minor cell pressure is built up, and therefore it forces the burning gases out into the main combustion chamber. Getting so whatever the burning droplets are there, whatever the flaming droplets are there in a minor cell, they are to be forces into the main combustion chamber, and thereby creating the additional swirling motion or turbulence or ordered or disordered motion in a main combustion chamber, and producing the better combustion in this chamber. Getting so here again the bulk combustion will be occurs in a main combustion chamber. So in meantime the pressure is built up in the major cell. As here whatever the combustion products or combustion that droplets are there, when it is forces from minor cell to the main chamber, during that period what happens, the pressure is built up in a major cell, which then prolongs the action of jet stream entering the main chamber. Getting, because of this pressure which is in the major cell, it prolongs the combustion. Getting, it prolongs the combustion in a main combustion chamber, thus continuing to induce the turbulence in the main chamber. Getting, so due to the whatever the combustion that products that is to be processed from minor cell to the main chamber, during which pressure is created, and this pressure is very much helpful to prolong the this combustion droplets to be entering into the main combustion chamber. Getting, so that is about the energy cell or air cell. It is again very complex in terms of the design and construction of these cells into the cylinder head. Getting, now we'll see the M combustion chamber. We'll see the M combustion chamber. So M combustion chamber, that is a special type of open combustion chamber. Getting, it is a special type of open combustion chamber. So during the research, 25 years research, in 1954, Dr. Murer from Germany, he developed the M process combustion this chamber. It is called the M process combustion chamber without typical diesel combustion noise. Means the noise created by this type of combustion chamber is not like typical diesel engine. This noise is not more as compared as the typical or conventional diesel engines are going to be produced, and hence this type of combustion chamber is also called as a whisper engines due to the less noise created by this type of combustion chambers. So the M combustion chamber is special type of open combustion chamber having the combustion chamber in a piston cavity. If you see here, in a piston the cavity is provided. Such cavity is provided in a piston. Beside you, this is a top view. Meaning, so such a cavity is provided in the piston crown. So it differs in principle from other open combustion chambers designs in that fuel spreads over the surface of spherical cavity in the piston. Here fuel is to be injected through the injector, that is again the multi-point or multi-hole that injectors, and this fuel is to be strikes on the cavity, on the surface of cavity, and where it spreads over this surface of this cavity. Getting, surface of the cavity. So in diesel engine such that formation is not happening. Getting, in the diesel engine, in typical diesel engines, the fuel is not strike on the walls. Getting, before that only they are going to mix with the air, but in this case it is not happening. In this case the fuel is injected and it will be strikes with the cavity walls, cavity surface, and it will be spreads over this cavity surface. Getting, it will spreads over the cavity surface. So the fuel is here, it differs in the principle of other open combustion chamber designs. So the fuel is injected tangentially from multi-hole nozzle on the surface chamber in the direction of the air swirl, in the direction of the air swirl, and the injected fuel forms the film around 0.15 mm thick on the surface of this chamber. So the film will be formed on the surface of the chamber, and the combustion is initiated by auto-ignition of small portion of fuel which is airborne at very beginning. Airborne means when fuel is injected through this injector, during which only the fuel is to be mixed with the air, and this airborne fuel is formed the film over this surface, over this cavity. And when it forms the film over this cavity, what happens? The auto-ignition of a very small part of this film is going to be start. It is going to be initiate, and thereby it is going to cause the combustion inside the combustion chamber. When a small portion of this fuel is to start to burn due to the auto-ignition. So amount of this airborne fuel is controlled by selecting a proper distance between the nozzle tip and combustion chamber wall. So whatever the amount of fuel that we are going to form the film, that will depends upon this position of this injector, correct? Position of this injector and the combustion chamber wall distance. Getting so distance between the injector and wall, there will be on over which it depends the formation of the film. Getting so subsequently the fuel vapors rise from hot wall and are mixed with the swirling air in successive layers, and combustion takes place nearly homogeneous air fuel mixture. Means likewise in a petrol engine, how that combustion will be happening, same way here homogeneous air fuel mixture will be formed and it going to be burn due to the initiation of the small portion of the fuel. Getting, and in this manner, in this case, the whatever the combustion that will be similar to the petrol engine or SI engine. Getting, so advantage is that pressure rise is a lower, low peak pressure, again the smoke level also less, ability to operate on a wide range of liquid fuels, so multi fuel capability, no combustion noise, noise is less, and that's why called the whisper engine. Then disadvantage of M chambers, getting disadvantage of this M chambers. Now fuel vaporization depends upon the surface temperature, means auto ignition of this fuel depends upon the temperature of the surface, and because of that maybe chances that is a cold starting problem arises, so again needs some aids for the cold starting. Then it creates the white smoke, diesel odor, means smell of the diesel will be going to be occur in the exhaust, high hydrocarbon emission may occur. Also it will reduces the volumetric efficiency. Getting, so M combustion chamber, that is simply it is a type of open combustion chamber, that is a special chamber. Getting, where the combustion will be occur like in SI engine. Getting, now here we discuss the comparison between open chamber and divided chamber, that is a DI chamber and IDI chambers. So according to the fuel used, so in this case good ignition quality fuel is needed. Getting, mean shorter delay period, shorter ignition delay or higher Cten number fuel is to be desirable in this case in open chamber. In divided chamber, consume fuels of poor ignition quality or longer ignition delay or lower Cten number, mean fuel is not important. Getting, any kind of fuel is to be used in this case. So type of injection nozzles used here, multiple hole injection, means multi hole injection nozzles are to be needed because to create the high injection pressures. Getting, and for proper mixing of fuel and air, because swirling motion is less in this case. Here it is able to use the single hole injection injectors or pintail or pintox, because in this case we require the moderate injection pressure. Getting, also the swirling that is already due to the divided chambers, this mixing is proper or mixing is good in this case. Then sensitivity of fuel, open chamber is sensitive, divided chamber is a insensitive. Getting, divided chamber is a insensitive, means here the fuel quality much needed, here multi fuel ability. Mixing of fuel and air is not so efficient, thus high air fuel ratio are not feasible without smoke. Use of higher fuel ratio without smoke due to the proper mixing, as here proper mixing is there due to the swirling motion, here proper mixing is not happening. Cylinder construction here is very simple, there is no any other construction is to be needed. Getting so whole combustion chamber, main combustion in a main engine cylinder only. Total volume of the combustion chamber used to be in a main chamber only, engine cylinder only. More expensive engine cylinder construction. Getting more, that is expensive because this divided chamber is again located in the cylinder head. That's why the construction is a complex one and expensive one. Starting, better cold starting. Easy to put cold starting. It is difficult for the cold starting. It requires some aids. Requires some that additional devices should be needed to avoid the cold starting. Thermal efficiency, more thermal efficiency, higher thermal efficiency. Thermal efficiency is a lower due to the loss of heat from main chamber to the additional chamber. Now lastly, we discuss the cold starting of CNGs. Cold starting of CNGs. So cold starting of CNGs, easy starting from cold is very important. Getting easy starting from cold is very important requirement of CNG. So to ensure easy cold starting, we are going to desirable to use the high compression ratio engine. Getting it is to be used to avoid the cold starting. So cold starting also becomes difficult in case of extreme cold climate like Himalaya regions, when the cylinder liner is heavily worn, when the valves are leaky, correct? So it is therefore sometime necessary to provide some electrical aids for cold starting. Open chamber or direction injection engines are easier to cold start because of the reasons. That is, the first, surface to volume ratio, that is a less, and because of that loss of heat is a less. Also swirl intensity is a less, and because of that swirl intensity is lower, the gas film remain on cylinder walls. Meaning gas film remains on the cylinder walls, and which reduces the heat loss, which reduces the heat transfer. So there are different methods are there to achieve easy cold starting. Few of them are described here. So injection of small quantity of lubricating oil or fuel oil. Getting injection of small quantity of lubricating oil or fuel oil. So this is a temporary method. Getting this is a temporary method to raise the compression ratio by sealing the piston rings and valves. Second, provision of cartridge. So this may be self igniting or requiring igniting before the insertion of the combustion chamber. Then starting a petrol engines, the engine is provided with sparking plug and carburetor. At starting, compression ratio is reduced by providing an auxiliary chamber, and engine is started as a petrol engine. Getting means starting like a petrol engine. Then preheating the engine manifold or engine cylinder by warm water. Getting so by warm water only also we are going to preheat the engine cylinder. Then modified valve timings for starting. Modifying the valve timing for starting. And then the modern, there are modern some techniques are there, namely electric glow plugs in combustion chamber. Electric glow plugs are used to be in combustion chamber. Then manifold heaters which ignite a small feed of fuel. Then injection into intake of controlled amount of low ignition temperature liquids. Getting by injection of ethyl ether with additional other fuel, one can also avoid the cold starting problem. So the injection into the intake of controlled amount of low ignition temperature liquids, getting namely ethyl ether with additional other fuels, cold starting also we can overcome this problem. Thank you. So this is a last that content of this chapter, that is a cold starting. So hope you understood all these content we are discuss here. If any questions arise, then you can put the comments in the video in the Google Classroom or on the WhatsApp. Correct? Thank you. Thank you very much.